CW presents Sesame Street Show 1999, produced in color at Reeves Teletape.
Why, I'm the early bird. I got up bright and early because Luis, you know, so has a broken arm, and he's going to need a helping bird around. And I see him right over there.
Okay.
Here's a helping bird. Now, where can I start?
Oh, hi, Big Bird.
Hi, Luis.
Well, listen, Bob's already been helping me here. Thanks a lot, Bob.
Yeah, your shoelace is all tied now.
Okay. How about if I go back to your apartment and make your bed for you?
Oh, I just did that a few minutes ago, Big Bird. Thanks, anyway. Listen, I've got to run. I have a piano lesson in about 2 minutes.
Okay.
See you later.
Thanks
Anything
again.
Else you need.
Right.
See you, Big Bird.
Bye, Bob.
Nice guy, eh?
Yeah, but, you know, maybe he made your bed, but I bet he didn't put your toys away.
Oh, well, I don't have any toys, Big Bird. Now, look, I really appreciate it. I know you want to help, but you don't have to do anything.
But I want to, Luis. Oh, I know. What? Have you had your breakfast yet?
Well, no, but...
Say no more. This helping bird will have it ready faster than you can say,
Luis, your breakfast is ready.
Oh, okay. Yeah, listen, I'm sorry, Big Bird, but Maria already is making my breakfast for me. I'm sorry. Listen, I really appreciate it. I know that you want to help me. But just knowing that you want to help makes me feel a lot better. All right? Well, listen, I better go now because my breakfast will get cold.
Yeah.
All right, I'll see you later.
Okay. Doesn't make me feel any better. I really want to do something to help. Oh.
Hey, Bird.
Hi, Snuffy.
How are you doing?
Okay.
Oh, Bird. You don't look so happy. What's the matter?
Well, Snuffy, I've been trying to help Luis because he has that broken arm. But everybody else is already helping him already.
Oh.
There's nothing left for me to do.
That's too bad, Bird. By the way, how did Luis break his arm?
Well, he was busy in the fix-it shop and he fell.
Oh, dear. Oh, it's too bad he didn't have any snuffle padding.
Snuffle padding?
Yeah. When I was a baby, my mommy put snuffle padding all around my snuffle coop. So if I fell, I wouldn't hurt myself. It would be nice and soft, just like a pillow.
Oh, that's it!
What's it?
Oh, you just come with me and you'll see. Oh, boy.
Oh, boy. I love a mystery. Wait up, Bird.
Don't you just love my chair?
Your chair, huh? It happens to be my chair.
It's mine.
It's mine.
It's mine.
It's mine.
Please. Please stop. Let's be sensible about this. Why not simply share the chair? Phooey. Why don't I learn to keep my mouth shut?
Good heavens. What was that? My window. Why, look at my window. It's broken. Why, I wonder how that happened. But to figure that out, I'd need a detective. Come in. Who are you?
Sherlock Hemlock. The world's greatest detective.
Oh, yeah?
Ah, there's a mystery in the air.
There is?
I can feel it in my bones. Okay. Yes, the mist lies low on the meadow.
It does?
The gray clouds cover the moon.
They do?
Yes. Egad. What's your problem?
Well, you see, I was just sitting here, Mr. Hemlock, and all of a sudden there's this big crash, you see, and my window is broken back there, see?
Egad. Let me think.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, I have it.
You do?
Yes.
Already?
I know what to call this case. What? The case of the broken window.
Oh, brother.
Now, let's look for clues.
Okay.
What do you think it could have been that came through that window?
Well, that was what I was about to ask you. Or did I ask you that already?
I have it!
You
yes,
do?
A very small airplane was flying too low. It flew right in through that window into this room. Now, if we can find that plane, we will know all.
Yeah, well, gosh, Mr. Hemlock, I don't see any plane around here, but, Hey, look at this.
What's that?
Well, it appears to be a baseball.
Why, so it does, a baseball.
Perhaps it was this baseball that came through that window.
Young man, in my opinion, it was that baseball which came in through your window.
Why, that's fantastic thinking, Mr. Hemlock. Now, if we can only figure out who caused this baseball to come through that window.
Well, you look over there, and I'll look over here.
But, Mr. Hemlock, Wait a minute. What's this in your hand?
It appears to be a baseball bat.
Yes. Mr. Hemlock!
Yes?
Turn around. What's this? What's this on your back?
Oh, that's number 5. That's my number on the Sesame Street Sluggers. I'm shortstop, you know. Yes, baseball's my favorite sport.
But...
Hey, oh, there you are, Sherlock. Come on, the whole game is waiting for you. Oh, hi, Ernie. Hey, you should have seen the great home run this guy Sherlock just hit. He tied up the whole score. Hey, come on.
That may be a clue.
You, Mr. Hemlock, were the one who hit that home run which knocked this baseball right through my window.
Egad, that's it. Yes, quite. Sherlock Hemlock has solved another mystery and also tied the score.
Yeah, but...
Tut, my boy. No elaborate reward is necessary. Simply return my baseball will be sufficient.
Yeah, but, Mr. Hemlock, here's your baseball. It's another window.
H.
Right. How many things begin with the letter H?
Hair.
Oh, yeah. Head. Hair.
Hair.
What's pointing?
Hand.
Right.
Shake.
No shaking, yeah. Hands.
Yeah.
Begin with the letter H, right?
Heel.
Ooh.
Heart. Dum, 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 dum.
Yeah, another H.
Horse.
Hey, yeah, a lot of animals begin with H, too. Horse, yeah. How about, what's this going to be? Look at that.
Hawk.
A hawk, right. Oh, that's a beautiful one. Look at that, you dropped a feather, too. Hen.
Hippopotamus.
Oh.
It's
a biggie, isn't it?
H.
Yeah. Hey, what kind of things can we do that begin with the letter H? Let's see. How about hiking?
Yeah. And horseshoes. Hula hoop.
Wow, yeah. Hula hoop. Heather, too. Everything's with an H, isn't it? Yeah, big H.
boy with people. And birds have feathers. Raccoon. Nice soft fur. Fish scales. Turtle with shell. Porcupine that has prickles. Sheep have wool. Elephant has baggy or wrinkly skin. He has bumps. Rhino's bumpy skin. An alligator, hard, bumpy skin. Horse, soft, nice fur. Tigers have soft, striped fur skin. Zebra with soft, ripe, black and white fur skin. Reindeer is losing her hair. Too hot to wear that heavy coat all in the summer. The ape has beautiful hair.
Measuring, measuring. Using tools for measuring. Things that are worth treasuring. To learn how much there is. With a ruler you can measure all that has length, width and height. Perhaps a frame for your new picture, or a tail string for your kite. If it's weight you wish to measure, a scale's a thing that must be found. Everything from fish to fruitcake has a weight in ounce or pound. Thermometers are quite instructive when you wish to measure heat. Temperature is what they tell of your body, house or street. Measuring, measuring. Using tools for measuring. Things that are worth treasuring. To learn how much there is.
Well, Bert, how's it going?
Boy, Snuffy, this snuffle padding idea of yours is perfect. Now Luis can fall all he wants, and he won't be able to break anything.
Oh, well, I sure hope he likes it, Bert.
Don't worry, he will. I can't wait to see what he says.
Yeah, neither can I. But, I gotta go home now, Bert. I promised my mommy. You'll tell me how Luis likes it, okay?
Sure I will.
Okay. Bye-bye, Bert.
Bye, Snuffy. Boy, there goes a great Snuffleupagus. Oh, and Snuffy, thanks for the snuffle padding.
Thanks for the what?
Oh, a snuffle padding. But, Luis, it's a surprise. Hey, come on in. When do you see this?
What?
Snuffle padding. Ta-da!
Snuffle padding?
Yeah.
What's going on?
Well, see, it's Snuffy's snuffle padding from his old snuffle coop. Now, if you ever fall again, wherever you fall, it'll be soft.
Oh, Bird. You mean, you put all this up because you were worried about me falling again?
Well, yeah, maybe a little.
Oh, well, that's very nice of you to be concerned with me like that. But, you know, just because I fell down one time doesn't mean that I'm going to keep doing it over and over again.
Really?
As long as I'm careful, I have nothing to worry about.
Oh, does that mean that you won't want all this snuffle padding?
Well, I hope you won't be too upset, but the padding has got to come down. I'm sorry, Bert.
Oh, that's okay. I'm not upset, because now I have something I can help you do.
What?
I can help you take down all this snuffle padding. What would you do without me?
I don't know, Bert. I really don't know.
See what's in the firehouse.
I don't see any fires. But I do see a hat.
A what?
A hat.
Look over here. Wow, it's a huge O's.
A what?
O's, hose. And what's that?
That's a fire hook.
A fire what?
A fire hook. Hook.
What's a head hose hook?
Why are you asking me? I'm a dog.
So that's a head hose hook.
Hiya, 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 gang. This is Danny David giving you news on how to keep your feet happy and snappy. Now first you take your laces, and then you tie them like so. And then you take a hold of one side, and you make a little bow. And then you gather up the other side, and here's what you do. Now you swing around the bow, yes, you swing around the bow, and then you pull it right through. And then you tie it real tight. And once you've got it in a place, well, it's really kind of fun. And when you're done, that's what we call tying your shoelace. Tying your shoelace.
Easy as pie.
Tying your shoelace. All you gotta do is try. Oh, it's easy. It's real easy.
David, could I learn too?
Sure, just watch. It's easy. First you take your laces.
First you take your laces.
And then you tie them like so.
Then you tie them like so.
Then you take a hold of one side.
Take a hold of one side.
And you make a little bow.
Then you make a little bow.
And then you gather up the other side.
Gather up the other side.
And then here's what you do.
And here's what you do.
Now you swing around the bow. Yes, you swing around the bow. And then you pull it right through.
You pull it right through.
And then you tie it real tight.
Then you tie it real tight.
And once you've got it into place, now it's really kind of fun. And when you're done, that's what we call tying your shoelace.
And now will you tie my laces?
Sure, Harry. But wait a minute. You don't wear shoes.
Yeah, I know. But I collect them.
Once upon a time, there was a two that was more than just a two. It was Super Two.
Mine.
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 I hear trouble.
Mine. Mine, I have first.
This looks like a job for Super Two. Two dolls. Two little girls. Two trees. Two worms. Aww. Super Two.
Entrada. Thank you.
We take you now to Kermit the Frog with another fast-breaking news story.
Hello, hello, this is Green Frog calling CTW Central. Do you read me? Hello, hello, 10-4. Hi, all, this is Kermit the Frog speaking to you from the cottage. This is the cottage of the poor little shoemaker and his wife. Now, as you recall, the poor little shoemaker used up all his leather to make his last pair of shoes, and now he has no more leather and no more shoes.
Hey, will you keep it down? I'm trying to sleep up here.
I'm sorry about that.
All right.
Okay.
Okay.
It's very touchy. In any case, I think somebody is coming in here now. Let's see whom it is. Pardon me, this is the cottage of the poor little shoemaker. Can I ask whom you are?
Gee, guys, look, it's Kermit the Frog from the Sesame Street News.
In person.
Gee, we watch you every night.
Oh, good.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. We're elves, and yeah. I'm Squeaky.
I'm Sneaky.
And I'm Leaky.
Uh-huh, well, I'm sorry to hear that, but I've heard of you elves. You come to people's houses in the middle of the night and help them out, is that right?
Yeah. Oh, you got it, Frog. Mm-hmm. When they wake up in the morning, mm-hmm. there's presents from us. Ah. Hey, we ought to bring them on in here.
Okay, well, viewers, you heard it right from the elves' mouths. These elves are going to work all night, and when the poor little shoemaker wakes up in the morning, he's going to have a whole bunch of new shoes to sell. Let's watch. Here comes the first shoe now. Pardon me, Squeaky?
No, I'm Sneaky.
Sneaky, I forgot. What is this thing here?
It's Stew. What's it look like, a trampoline?
Stew? No, wait a second. You're supposed to bring a shoe. Now, Stew rhymes with shoe, but you're supposed to bring a shoe.
Sorry about that.
Listen, what is this? This is a canoe.
Yeah.
Now, canoe also rhymes with shoe, but you're supposed to bring a shoe, not a canoe. Listen, Squeaky.
No, I'm Leaky. This is my canoe.
This is a leaky canoe?
Yeah.
Wait a minute. Wait. Now, that's a kangaroo. Now, kangaroo also rhymes with shoe. But you guys are supposed to bring shoes, not stews and canoes and kangaroos. Come on now.
What is going on down here? Can't a man and his wife get some sleep? What is this?
Look, poor little old shoemaker husband, dear. It's the elves.
Yeah. There seems to be some sort of a problem. They were supposed to bring you shoes, but instead they brought you a...
Look, Stew. And a canoe.
Yeah.
And a darling kangaroo.
Yeah, you don't understand. You see the...
Hey, Squeaky. Hey, all this stuff looks like terrific. This is wonderful.
Hey, wait a second. Do you know these guys?
Hmm? Oh, sure. Last time they brought us some glue and a honeydew and a tube of shampoo. Yeah, and a case of the flu.
Yeah,
but you still don't have any leather and you don't have any shoes. What about your shoe business?
Well, I'll tell you the truth, Frog. I was never good at the shoe business. I think maybe I'll be a lawyer. Hey, that's it. I'll be a lawyer. Okay, line up for Stew, guys. Here we go.
Oh, you all right now. I'll get the ball.
Well, this is Kermit the Frog speaking to you from the cottage of the poor little shoemaker or the poor little lawyer. And, returning you to your regularly scheduled program.
Get out of my house, Frog.
Yes, there's no business like shoe business, folks.
H. Hair. H.
You know, we've got all this time off, so what are we going to do? I know, let's go to the movies.
No, it's such a pretty day to spend inside a movie theater. Let's go to the park.
No, I want to go to the movies.
Oh, let's go to the park.
I want to go to the movies.
Let's go to the park.
You know, it really must be fun being the two-headed monster, you know? I mean, can you imagine? You actually get to hold a conversation with yourself.
I wonder...
You know, let's just imagine what it would be like to be the two-headed monster.
Okay, I got a joke.
What?
Why did the chicken cross the road?
I don't know why.
To get to other side. All right. No more laughing. We have to sweep.
No. Rest.
No west sweep.
No rest.
And no west we must sweep.
No rest.
No resting we sweeping.
No resting.
Okay, no resting. You sweep.
Sweep.
No, I'm gonna rest.
No, we got to sweep.
I don't wanna sweep. I wanna rest.
We got to sweep.
I don't wanna sweep. I wanna rest.
We got to sweep.
No sweeping, resting.
We got to sweep.
I'm resting.
We got to sweep.
I told you I was resting. Look, you, I'm resting.
Well, maybe it wouldn't be that much fun after all.
It must be difficult to make up your mind when you have two heads.
Yeah. Well, let's go to the movies anyway.
No, let's go to the park.
No, the movies.
The park.
The movies.
The park.
The movies.
The park.
The movies.
The park.
No, the movies.
The movies.
No, okay, the movies.
The park.
No, not the park. The movies.
The park.
The movies.
Now let's go.
Okay, to the park. We can go.
It's not outside in, it's not inside out. But still, I got some trouble here that I have to think about. It's a problem I've had since I was 2 years old. That's how to get this button through that old buttonhole. Oh, how do you get that button through that old buttonhole?
Seven. Where is that thing? Eight. Nine. And 10.
Hi there. Today I would like to discuss hope with you. Okay?
Hey, Ernie.
Well, hi there.
Hi.
Hey, listen, would you like to discuss hope with me?
Sure, why not?
Okay. Now, I have something inside this paper bag.
Oh, you do, huh?
Now, you don't know what's in this bag, do you?
No.
Okay. Now, is there anything that you would like there to be in this bag?
Oh, yes.
Mm. And what, pray tell, is that, as if I didn't know?
Cookie!
A cookie. You would like there to be a cookie inside this bag.
You bet. Cookie!
Now, observe that you don't know for a fact that there is indeed a cookie inside this bag, do you?
Can I peek?
No, you can't peek.
Oh, no, I do not know.
Okay, but the bag is just about the right size to hold a cookie.
Yeah, so it might be a cookie.
Yes, it might.
Goody, it's a cookie. Give me
cookie. No, wait a minute. You don't know that for sure.
No, but I want it to be a cookie.
Exactly, you want it to be a cookie, and another way to say that is that you hope that this is a cookie.
I hope that is a cookie, yeah.
Okay, but it might not be a cookie.
Oh, I hope it's a cookie real bad.
It might be a bunch of thumbtacks.
Thumbtacks? No, I hope it's a cookie.
Or it could be like a box of crayons.
Oh, even. No, I want it to be a cookie.
Well, I won't keep you in suspense any longer.
Oh, goody, give me cookie.
It is not a cookie.
Not a cookie?
Nope. It is not a cookie. It is, in fact...
No cookie.
10 cookies.
10 cookies?
Yep, it's 10 cookies.
Oh, boy.
Rather, it's 9 cookies there. Possibly 8 cookies. Anyway, I hope that he enjoys the cookies.
I've got a mind. And my mind helps me. With everything I do, or... see. My mind tells me this is a square. If I add another, it's a pair. Add four more. Stack like blocks, and I've got enough to make a box. And now I use my mind to guide, my hands to find out what's inside. It's soft and wet and sticky too. My mind tells me that it is glue.
Ladies and gentlemen, we're proud to present the supergroup Mass Communication. In case you didn't know the name of that song, it was 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
There's the harbor. There are the boats and the water.
There's a lobster boat.
I think. Yeah, it's a lobster boat.
Was the lobster man's daughter?
She's looking up at some seagulls, and they're looking for food.
The man and the girl were throwing fish.
And there's the buoy. And take it up with, like, this little hook. And they put it on this crane.
It's like an electric wheel to crank up the lobster traps.
There's a lobster trap.
I wonder if he caught anything. There is a couple of lobsters in there. Now they're putting it down the boat side to get the lobsters out.
Here's a lobster. He's measuring of the little one from the big one. He threw it out because it was too little. Now they're putting on the rubber band.
So they can't harm anyone. They really hurt.
Now you put it in the bucket.
Safekeeping.
Now they're taking out the bait. No, they're taking out fishing crabs.
Putting more bait in there. Locked it up.
Here's another lobster trap, I think. Yeah, it is. Looks like little baby lobsters. Yeah, they do.
Putting it on the deck.
Now he's driving the boat again.
Oh, I love this pot. There goes boom. One lobster trap.
There goes another.
The day is done. Good catch.
Do you know what I'm doing with this letter H? Let me show you. With the letter H, I can make words like hat and horse. An H can make me feel like a hero. Whoa! Easy, easy. Another H word is hold.
How about heave?
You want to see how I look when I'm happy? How do you look when you're happy? Hey, how do you look when you're sad? Want to look and see how I look when I'm sad? Want to see how I look? How do you look when you're angry? Oh, you're good. Want to see how I look when I'm angry? Now, how do you look when you're proud? Hey, want to see how I look when I'm proud? Yeah, yeah. Now, how do you look when you're surprised? You're good. You want to see how I look when I'm surprised? Wow. Now, how do you look when you're afraid? Oh, you're a good actress. You want to see how I look when I'm afraid? Now, let's all both of them together, all right? Now, let's do happy. Now, let's do sad. Angry. Proud. Surprised. Afraid. You want to do them fast? Okay? Happy. Sad. Angry. Proud. Surprised. Afraid. Righty. You want to do them faster? No.
Mrs. Grocer.
Yes, sir. How are you today?
Do you have some nice potatoes?
I sure do. Just step this way.
Oh, so many nice potatoes.
Want to buy a pound or two?
And when I see potatoes, there's just one thing I must do. I must count. One potato, two potatoes, three potatoes, four. Five potatoes, six potatoes, seven potatoes more. Eight potatoes, nine potatoes, even more than ten. I will count all the potatoes, then I'll count them all again. 123, 124, 125 potatoes. Thank you very much. I'll be back later. Goodbye.
Mario, that guy who always counts the potatoes is just here again.
Well, here I am at another shop. Oh, it looks like it might rain. There's something else I might go shopping for. Hello there, Mr. Salesman.
Yes, sir. How are you today?
Do you have some nice umbrellas?
Yes, I do. Please step this way.
Oh, so many nice umbrellas.
Just the thing when raindrops fall.
And when I see umbrellas, I just have to count them all. Oh, one umbrella, two umbrellas, three umbrellas, four. Five umbrellas, six umbrellas, seven umbrellas more. Eight umbrellas, nine umbrellas, even more than ten. I will count all the umbrellas, then I'll count them all again. 30, 31, 32 umbrellas. Thank you very much. I'll be back later. Goodbye.
Maurice, there was just a weirdo in here counting the umbrellas.
Well, here I am a little way down the street, and look, a little newsstand. Hello, dear newsstand person.
Hi, what can I do for you?
Do you have some nice newspapers?
Well, just look, of course I do.
Oh, a great big pile of newspapers. To read them would be fun. But when I see newspapers, I must count them one by one. Oh, one newspaper, two newspapers, three newspapers, four. Five newspapers, six newspapers, seven newspapers, more. Eight newspapers, nine newspapers, even more than ten. I will count newspapers, then I'll count them all again. 76, 77, 78 newspapers. Thank you very much. I'll be back later. Goodbye.
Every day that man comes and counts all my newspapers. Enough to make a person angry.
Well, here I am, back in the grocers again. You know, I like to go shopping, but I love counting so much it's very hard to get any shopping done. Oh, one potato, two potatoes, three potatoes, four. Five potatoes, six potatoes, seven potatoes, four. Eight potatoes, nine potatoes, even more than ten. Oh, let me count the potatoes over and over again.
Entrada. Salida.
Say, that pogo stick looks like fun.
Sure is. Wanna try?
Oh, I'd love to.
What's that?
I say, I'd love to.
Oh, all right. Here. There's two.
Stop! No one crosses this bridge by me unless they can answer my questions three.
All right, bridge keeper. What are the questions?
What is this?
A square.
How many sides does a square have?
One, two, three, four. Four sides.
What is a square good for?
My building blocks. Look. They're square.
All right. You may pass. Stop! No one crosses this bridge by me unless they can answer my questions three.
Okay.
What is this?
A square.
How many sides does a square have?
Four equal sides.
What is a square good for?
Look, a square makes a nice picture frame.
You may pass. Stop! No one crosses this bridge by me unless they can answer my questions three. What is this?
Oh, a square!
How many sides does a square have?
Four.
What is a square good for?
Good for? These things are great. I eat three square meals every day.
Circle.
No. No.
Circle!
Yeah.
Circle!
Bye-bye.
Gorilla. G.
I got chilly. I'm gonna put a sweater on. I'm gonna try to put a sweater on. Let's see. If I put this like this. Oh.
Hi, Luis. Your ever helpful friend is back.
Hi, Bert. Am I glad to see you?
You are?
Yeah, I'm trying to put the sweater on here. Could you help me?
Oh, sure. Oh,
okay.
Sure.
All right. Well, just kind of pull down the back there a little bit, okay? Well, I thought you were going to help me.
Well, I am helping you. I'm helping you by not helping you.
Huh?
Well, I just got to thinking. What happens if it gets cold and you don't know how to put your sweater on and I'm not here to help? Why, you better practice putting your sweater on now without any help.
Yeah, you're right. Yeah, I should try to put it on myself. Okay, yeah. Let's see. Right, so, where's that? Okay, here we go. No.
You can do it now.
Okay. Oh, no, I can't do this.
Sure, don't give up. You always tell me to practice and learn things.
Okay. All right. Okay. Well, let's see. Let's try this. Where's here? This.
Not easy, is it?
No, it isn't. Okay. See. Now, put this like this. And two, three.
Hey,
I did it.
Look at that.
I
you got it on.
Yeah.
See? You did it. I told you you could.
Yeah, thanks a lot, Big Bird. You helped a lot. Really.
You're welcome.
Yeah, but you know, after all that work, I'm warm now. I don't need the sweater.
Don't move, Bert.
Okay.
Almost got it here.
I don't want to see it, Ernie.
Here we go. And it is finished.
Oh, boy. Let me see.
Okay, Bert.
Okay.
Take a look at it here.
Okay.
How's that?
Oh, wow. That's great, Ernie. Hey, but, Ernie?
Yes?
It's not quite finished. I mean, it looks almost finished, but it's not quite finished.
Almost? Why, what do you mean, Bert? It looks exactly like you.
Ernie, part of the face is missing there.
Part of the face is missing?
Yeah.
Well, what do you mean, Bert?
Well, look at that
Everything
face and
is
then
there.
Look at my Let's, face and see.
Well, see, it's got two eyes up there.
Yeah, and I have two eyes too, yeah.
Mm-hmm. It's got two ears.
Two ears. I have two ears.
You have two ears. It's got a mouth.
A mouth. I've got a mouth too, yeah.
It's got eyebrows.
Yep, two eyebrows.
Yeah,
I mean, I have eyebrows too, yeah.
It's got a nose. Oh, Bert.
You forgot the nose.
I forgot the nose.
Right.
How could I do that? Well, don't worry, Bert. I'll just get some more clay
okay,
here.
I'll stand still here.
Oh, no.
What?
Why, Bert.
What?
I'm all out of clay.
Oh, no.
I don't have any more clay. What'll I do?
Oh, gee, I don't know, Ernie. It looks so nice except for the nose.
Well, Bert.
What?
I have an idea. Come here a second, Bert.
Oh, yeah? You going to tell me? What is it?
Yeah.
What is it?
Just come here.
Oh, tell me a secret?
Mm-hmm. Ah! Just a bit of... There we go. Perfect.
I don't understand.
A.
B.
C. D. E.
F.
G. J. K.
L.
M.
N.
Oh. P. Q. R.
I was taking a bath, long about a Saturday night. Yeah. Rubbed up, just relaxing in the tub, thinking everything was all right. Well, I stepped out the tub, put my feet on the floor. I wrapped the towel around me and I opened the door. And then a flip flash, I jumped back in the bath. Well, I was out of know there was a party going on. There was a fishing and a flash, and the rhythm was the feeling, moving and a groove.
We give these elephants a bath every day of the year because they do need it, and we use a special shampoo that puts the oils back in their skin that the sun takes out.
Do you keep them fit in a bathtub?
No. Yeah, we lay them down on one side. We just take two big scrub brushes and we scrub them down behind the ears, underneath the belly. See, it's very helpful for them, and it keeps their toenails soft and keeps their skin soft.
It's not like washing a car. They have a lot of personality, and each one of them is different, of course.
Big bang, I saw the whole gang dancing on my living room rug. Yeah, flip-flops, they were doing the bop. All the teens had the dancing bug. There was a lollipop with a peggy shoe. Golly, Miss Molly was a even there too. Well, a splish-splash, I forgot about the bath. I went and put my dancing shoes on. Yeah, I was a rolling and a strolling, feeling with the feeling, moving and a groove. Pushing and a splashing. Hey, yeah!
Gorilla begins with G. Oop, G for gone. G for go. And get. Oops. G also for glass. G for ground. And grow. And garden. G for gallop. And also, goodbye!
Oh, gosh.
What's the matter, Louis?
Oh, I got an itch inside the cast and I can't reach it. It's driving me crazy.
Would it help if you try scratching the outside of the cast real hard?
Nah, that's not gonna help. I tried that.
Well, maybe if you scratch the same place on your other arm.
No, Bert, I don't think that's gonna help, no.
Wait a minute. I know what you have to do.
What?
I'll show you. See, first you stand on one leg, and then you put one finger on your beak, in your case, a nose, and then you hop all the way around.
Bert, I can't do that. Come on.
Well,
I feel
why not?
Too silly, that's why.
Well, it can't hurt. Try it. Besides, maybe if you feel silly, you won't feel the itch.
Well, why not? Okay. Now, how was that again?
Put your finger on your nose.
Finger on my nose.
1 foot.
1 foot up.
Now, hop around. Like that. Keep doing it.
Hey, it's working.
Sesame Street has been brought to you today by the letters G and H and by the number 2. Sesame, the Children's Television Workshop.